Welcome back to the workshop. Today we're doing an unboxing because I wanted to get this thing on screen the minute the package from the Ukraine showed up. ICM loves the channel. I love ICM. They have such nice model kits. This is their all new, brand spanking new. It's seen at every single VFW right next to an M60 sitting out front. The AH-1G Cobra early production U.S. attack helicopter. It's kit number 32060. These are out right now. You can snag these from your favorite hobby retailer. 1/32 scale. Look at that beauty. Oh, nice big 1/32 scale. Four options in the box for different Cobras. Let's take a look at everything that's in this enormous box so that you will want to pick yours up. First up, let's take a look at an ICM manual. I don't show enough manuals on the thing. And modern kits, the manuals are really getting amazing. This thing, for one, is more of a pamphlet than an actual instruction sheet. It's going to let you know in these red marks that there are things that will not be used on this kit. And you know what that means if you know anything about model kits. It's that the parts will be used on different variants. So this will not be the only one. Clearly, saying early production on the box means that we're going to see other production models. But ICM directions, they don't put too much into one step. That's what's so nice. So if you're not a big aircraft builder, you can easily build ICM aircraft because they break everything down so nicely. Beautiful drawings, full lined, extremely crisp. I mean, they get down to just, you know, okay, other companies would have you do like 32 different steps on this. They're just like, put the correct tail on, put this sight, put this in here, and you're done. This step over here, just put these two parts on here. That's it. How did those two parts go together? That's it right there. I love them. In the back of the manuals, they will tell you how to mount weapons for depending on what variant you want to build. Mask templates to paint your masking on. How to put the weapons on. How to put wheels on for flight fields with wheels that are required. And then full color callouts. And ICM's has got their own paint line coming out too, I hope to show you. You can order a kit with its exact matching paint set and get that all done up. So we'll take a look. That's the beautiful manual in there. Let's get a look at the new styrene. I know you're excited. And at the end of this video, we'll be still shots of every single tree, sometimes two-sided, the decal sheet and the clear part. So you'll be able to check those out. But look at this. We'll do these with the HD camera on. Beautiful panel lines. I know 1/32 scale aircraft builders are big on panel lines and accuracy. Nice little rivets. Not too big, not too small. Nice little cockpit on there. I'm sure the aftermarket folks are going to go nuts on this with miles of photo etch and resin parts. Look at that nice back wall there. The quilted pattern on there. Excellent venting, side pod mounts, nice and large. So even though it's kind of a butt joint, it slips right in. Model glue holds it right in. Modern molding, especially ICM's, is so crisp. They do such a beautiful job. We're going to have two identical trees here of weapons pods and different small parts. Check out the tiny little shackles there. All these fine tubing and wiring attached with large enough space from the sprue to snip it off. Look at the back of the little missile pods. All their little levers. We got the tips, just the tip. But it's even inset, so it gives you a 3D. That is exquisite. Little black wash in there. All these little tiny pieces. I am not an aircraft expert, and I never pretend to be. All these little eyelets again. So I will name things wrong, and I don't care. I don't have to know the name of it to enjoy building a model, and neither do you. You can just look at the levers, or piping, tubing. This is just always so stunning. Beautiful to see these new kits. So that's one. Two of those trees, so you have enough to do both sides of the Cobra. Like saying Cobra 2, G.I. Joe. You can see the variants coming up. We've got one set of tail, two set of tail, excellent engraving on both. I'm sure the aircraft experts out there will say, hey, Chris, that one on screen at this time is for this variant of the Cobra, and that's the next variant they're going to produce, and that's awesome. Love those kind of constructive comments. If you're a tool bag about it, I just delete it. Look at that beautiful feathering down there on that wing blade, on the chopper blade. All the little stacking there. The blades are two-piece. We got a one-piece tail rotor. Look how sharp that's molded and crisp. Absolutely no flash, no short shots so far that I see. There we can see that feathering even nicer on that blade. Extreme detail. Love it. Check out that. The sides of the engine intakes. I think they're intakes. Looks like some fins there for the side pods. Nicely molded. Beautiful work all the way around. You can see the inside of those blades where they'll go together. Has locating pins. Soak those with a little bit of model glue. We'll get everything together beautifully. Awesome sauce. Dropping stuff on the table, getting a little excited. Here we've got, looks like the under fuselage. Nice detail. We got turbine parts. Check out these long tubes, these wires here. All one piece, no butt joins. Looks like top of the rotor here. Beautiful detail. I just love opening a model kit. The smell of the new plastic, all those parts you've never seen before. Here's a gauge cluster. Not such prominent detail on there that if you put the decals on, you got to shave it all off and stuff like that. You could actually leave it and the decals will set into it. Got another gauge cluster there. We got landing gear set up. One set up. Two set up. We got what looks like exhaust routing. And again, another closer look at the panel lines on that bottom. Subtle, but beautiful. And that's it for the gray styrene. Let me switch sides on the table. We got the awesome cockpit glazing, so you can mount it open or closed. We got some bubble work. We got some fine lights here. All very small parts, but mounted on the sprue in a way that you can snip them off without damaging them. Look how crystal clear that glass is. Wonderful. No seams down the middle. No nothing. Little grab handle in there. And the top. Wonderful. And then where they would join is where you'll be masking and running your paint. So they're just going to look awesome. We've got the decals, decals, the guys overseas say. You can pause it right there and look at them for the four variants. We'll come in nice and close. We got our gauges, different markings, high visibility stuff, all the different shaft access, drive shaft access, caution, everything it should have on it without getting too pedantic. 1/32nd scale, you can put a lot of detail in there. Load per applicable aircraft instruction. Got the Confederate flag, the Executioner logos, the Cavalry logos. All the beautiful stuff on there. Let you see, and I'll have a still shot of this at the end. That is everything in the massive AH-1G Cobra early production U.S. attack helicopter from ICM, 1/32nd scale. We're going to go over to the photo area, get you photos of those sprues so you can scrutinize them closer, and we'll see all of you at the next review.